My friends, hello and welcome to Perfect Dark Speed Lore, the series where we examine the world records set throughout the ages on a stage in Perfect Dark and share the stories of the speedrunners who performed these amazing runs all through the lens of the speedrun world record progression. Tonight, indeed, we've just seen the GoldenEye re-release on Switch and Xbox only a couple days ago, so hey, why not jump into Perfect Dark? You know, that's the way things are sometimes in speed lore, but we've got a good dandy tonight for you all. Tonight we're going to look at Extraction, Special Agent, and Perfect Agent, the third stage in Perfect Dark. And it's quite an interesting stage because this Datadyne mission, your first mission in Perfect Dark, you know, in both Perfect Dark and GoldenEye, you get these kind of sets of missions with a couple levels strung together. And this one, you infiltrate, defect into the Datadyne building, and your goal is to extract the Dr. Carol artificial intelligence. You know, you at first you think it's a real doctor, but it's actually an artificial intelligence computer who kind of flies around. Your goal is to get him out of the building and into the hands of good actors at the Carrington Institute rather than the bad guys. So, what do? Well, we have five objectives on Perfect Agent and four on Special Agent. The five on Perfect are access foyer elevator, just get onto a lift. Reactivate office elevator, that one is Perfect Agent only, you'll see it when it comes up. Three, destroy Datadyne hovercopter. That one's interesting because you can do it at many different points in the stage if you want, but we almost always traditionally do it at the end of the stage. So we'll see that. Defeat Cassandra's bodyguards. There's a bunch of guards strewn throughout the level, which is interesting. And then rendezvous with helipad is just get to the end. So that is always cool and dandy stuff. The first run we're going to watch tonight is by a fellow PD 4FR, Extraction PA255. We can see actually that there is a power outage in the Datadyne building once you've retrieved Dr. Carol on the previous mission, you know, to hinder your ability to get out. And there's all these guards who are, you know, fending you off. So usually you put on these night vision goggles and go for it. Of course, you know, you learn through time where the guards are located and how to avoid them well. I think on Agent, most of the time, you don't even turn it on anymore, the night vision goggles. I could be wrong about that. On Perfect Agent and Special Agent, I imagine you will mostly turn them on. It's one of those things where there's not too much time to be saved at the beginning because you're kind of, you're having to get this lift at the start. Yeah, pretty cool little feature there for the year 2000, you know. Ah, yeah, so JD Black, very well-versed Perfect Dark player, says if your TV's bright enough, you can get away with not having the night vision goggles turned on. But if you have a very dark, old, fading television, you might want to put it on. And we can see, you know, PD4FR here. This is a beginner entry run, is waiting for the lift, and Dr. Carol's there beside him, which is cool. Dr. Carol can pass away, actually, if he gets shot. On world record pace speedruns, you won't see him on the lift with you. You know, he'll be somewhere else. And so here's a trick that's been known about since the dawn of time, where you can open this door from behind through the wall. So, like, he just went through that door that would have been locked if not for him, you know, going through it, opening it from the back. And that's a pretty traditional trick in Perfect Dark. It was discovered very early on and helps immensely. Not only with speedrunning, but just beating the game at all. And, yeah, Cassandra's bodyguards are all these females with shotguns, which is quite interesting, you know. It was probably not very common to have, you know, female enemies with weapons back in 2000, you know, and it still isn't very common. So this, you know, game was probably groundbreaking to some extent in that regard. Of course, thematically, it makes sense that this Cassandra, you know, this sort of supervillain woman, head of a corporation, has a female entourage of bodyguards. That does make sense. And plus, you are Joanna Dark. You're a female protagonist. But it was probably not a very common thing at the time, so that's kind of interesting. Now, coming in here and pressing B at the computer is that objective 2. Activate the elevator, which is not on special agent. You don't have to do it. And then we can see Dr. Carroll is under attack, taking some damage. Luckily, in this case, not enough to pass away, but... And so, yeah, so right back there, we saw him go back into the lift and open the door again and now head upstairs. He had to go on that stage to eliminate the bodyguards, but is now progressing upwards. You know, you could just go progress upwards first, but then you would fail the bodyguards stuff. So you have to go on that stage and pass away those guards. And here, these four, you kind of get like a frozen mini cutscene there. You get the four bodyguards. The power goes out again. There is a light switch that you can turn on and kind of stuns the bodyguards, which is funny. There's four here on this floor, and then one, the last one is up above, and that's that objective. Then he's just going to have to shoot out the helicopter and call it a day, you know? So he's going, switching to the... getting that rocket launcher out, pulling off his night vision because it's too bright when you're outside. Here's the chopper. Now he's using the secondary function on the rocket launcher to ensure that it hits. Otherwise, you know, it's a bit intense and can sometimes you miss your shot. But with the secondary function, it like takes a while to kind of curve around and kind of heat seek the chopper. But anyways, there it is. Old objectives completed, bingo bango, 255. Nice run, cute run, solid run, and a very good introductory run to the stage. So huge thanks to PD4FR for that. Now, of course, throughout time, we see many, many ancient records, and our pal Joris has done a great job of... digging up this early history. And, you know, especially in Perfect Dark, the guys were sort of running and competing against each other from day one, which we see all the time now, but in the year 2000 it was very uncommon. It was very rare. It might be one of the first, you know, day one speed games. So the early records are not super well documented. We do have this 211 by Snapdragon, one of the founders of the community, and we just have a photograph screenshot here, which is pretty cool. I mean, even that is quite epic proof from the year 2000, this 211 perfect agent, and it was probably the untitled record when set, but we're not even sure for sure, right? Someone could have had lower. And so the first kind of world record run that we're going to show is this one by Marshmallow. 155 it's gonna be. And you know, Marsh is probably best known for having like the first ever full game GoldenEye speedrun. But it's actually gonna be interesting because we're gonna see a couple of these cases where there was guys who were mostly known for playing GoldenEye who dipped into Perfect Dark. And especially on this stage for some reason. So see, he doesn't even know that the about the door opening at that at this point in time. You know, this record was achieved August 2000. So that door opening deal, you know, wasn't super well known at this point, but it would be discovered pretty quickly. So he's gonna use the lift upwards. This is the most basic, most essential strategy on the stage. This is fully, you know, as intended. They are a good Mackie who says in chat that the colors in this game are intense. And I remember having discussions like back in 2006, 2007 about how Perfect Dark is so much more vibrant. You know, there's always, and this still exists to this day, always see an interesting sort of rush over to this guard and kind of taking refuge in the corner here. It's a good technique for this area, safe technique. There's always sort of friendly banter between guys who play more GoldenEye and guys who play more Perfect Dark, and so the sort of, oh, GoldenEye players, you know, Perfect Dark's too colorful for them, too bright. It was a common chirp back in the day. We always see again the heat-seeking secondary option, and you could see, right, if he just launched a rocket launcher at that, it would have hit like 3 or 4 seconds earlier, and he would have got like a 52, something like that, you know. So, yeah, hey, what can you say? 155 by Marsh, a very nice run, and indeed, it was the world record when set untied. So that's always nice. A couple months later, we would see this run, and again, I find this one quite interesting because it is from a gentleman, Wes McKinney. You know, Wes, I've talked in many lores before, would go on to found the Pandas library in the programming language. I think it's Python or something. You know, so he's gone on to great and wonderful things. He was one of the sort of founding fathers of the Perfect Dark Elite, GoldenEye Elite. And he was more of a GoldenEye player. And so it's interesting once again to see Wes get involved here and get a world record on the stage. And he actually got a few. He got, it looks like, 5 total world records on this stage, untieds. And again, he was more of a GoldenEye player, but because this game was still, like, you know, early, it was fresh, it was new, he was playing it. Let's take a look. So he just memorized the basement. He's not going to put on the glasses, which is interesting. And it kind of seems unnecessary. Well, he got right in there quick. So again, I mean, you can really see now that this is more of a speedrun. This is absolutely more of a speedrun, you know? This is going to run out of here. I mean, and considering this is Perfect Agent, you know, that's no easy task to run past guards. Activates the lift, goes back this way. Now, he doesn't know it yet. He could go back in the other lift, open the door, and go up the stairs instead of calling for this lift and waiting. But that would be discovered in due time. He's got a couple more bodyguards to deal with here. One there, two more here. Now, you know, the shotgun secondary function is a double pump. So you wonder if you could maybe get the two guards with one pump. That'd be pretty epic. Maybe someday, baby. Maybe someday. Nice shots there. Again, he's using this interesting technique of flooding into that corner. Seeking some refuge. Maintaining his health. I actually have not ever seen that specific technique for that room before. On Agent, you just run up and shoot a rocket launcher and like boost yourself while passing away all the 5 guards. Oh, so this is actually quite clever. He's going to shoot it from down here in hopes that he doesn't have to wait as long up here, which makes a lot of sense. Yeah, that was really well done. Like, that was a full-on speedrun. You know, I can't call that anything but a speedrun. And the time was 1:49, Perfect Agent. So a great job by Wes there. And yeah, one of his interesting dives into Perfect Dark, which is pretty cool. Alright, so here we have this post from Joris of this extraction special agent and perfect agent world record history. And we see some sort of like interesting stuff going on around this time, October 2000. We see Octowinky, and he posted an so Infiltrator posts extraction essay 141, no video. Same as Wes. Wes untied it, Infiltrator ties it. Octo posts that he got it, but the time was removed less than a week later, and he was banned from Perfect Dark. Now, I know that he actually faked photo proof of the end screens, which is kind of interesting. Again, not a huge drama or scandal. He would actually go on to become the GoldenEye proof moderator about 10 years later. You know, this is, I've been thinking about this lately, you know, seeing some more like cheating and gaming stuff come up about how cheating like is on a spectrum, right? Like on the closest end, the less egregious end, it's like you cheat in a game of dodgeball or backyard, you know, red A, you know, that game in the schoolyard. Oh no, the ball didn't graze me. That's like the least bad type of cheating, whereas the worst type of cheating is sort of like you know, Lance Armstrong in the Tour de France or whatever, or you know, cheating in the Olympics, right? It's a spectrum. Not all cheating is the same. And I've been thinking about that a lot lately. And so cheating by photoshopping end screens in Perfect Dark in 2000 when you were 15 years old is certainly closer to the less egregious end of cheating, in my opinion, you know. And so Octo and Tim Grenby seem to have lied or not spliced but photoshopped an end screen back in the day in Perfect Dark, and they were banned from Perfect Dark, which in retrospect seems actually quite heavy-handed. It seems quite heavy-handed, but it is what it is. You know, again, they would have Grenby would have a career in GoldenEye, and Octo would be the proof moderator, well, like community member for about 10 years. So you know, it's whatever. It does seem heavy-handed, but that's what that is. And it's just kind of interesting tidbit to see when you see all the world records, all the history laid out there. Again, it is interesting to see Infiltrator come up, because this is a guy who didn't play the game much. He played Perfect Dark like sort of a normal person would, just playing when it was new, kind of, in the first year, and then moved on to other games. I remember him in the community for a long time. He was kind of an older fellow, you know, I want to say 6 or 8 years older than me, and I remember he was pursuing a PhD and whatnot, and he was always a reasonable voice in the community. So I remember having many chats with him and always appreciating that kind of more mature outlook, especially when I was quite a silly poster back in that day. Now, he got Extraction SA 137 in January 01, and I was kind of amazed that he actually made a video of it. Like, the video was uploaded in 2009. And, you know, I joined the community around 05, and I never saw this guy be very interested in the games. So to see him upload a proof video of his old Untitled record, like, years after I thought he didn't care about the game anymore, is kind of fascinating. And I kind of wonder what the circumstances of him uploading this run was. Yeah, I mean, the aesthetic is so great here, you know. Hand cam holding this, you know, screen capture of this video. No door open yet either. And he's scrolling through here with the Falcon. This, again, is Special Agent, so he's not going to have to press B. You just have to shoot her from that. Lucky. He said he got lucky with the headshot there. You don't have to go and press B in there, so it's a little bit faster.
Sweet entry there.
Sweet entry to lift. Whoa, that was a double headshot right there. That was really good. That was really nice.
I'm so nervous here, I think. Line up the shot.
Oh, So we see Extraction Special Agent 137. Yeah, a lot of interesting stuff there. Switching to 1.2 for the stairs. I mean, I don't even know why he would do that. I would think 1.1 would kind of make sense. Let's see. Okay, so he switches to go icy. To maintain full speed up the stairs, he switched from 1.1 to 1.2, which actually does make sense now that you think of it. The more turning, that's where 1.1 loses time when you're turning, because it's analog as opposed to digital movement up the in the turns. So you're not always at full speed. And then we see him, not use the secondary function on the rocket launcher. Just got a nice fast shot there, which is the better strat. And so he got a 137, which is a good time. And yeah, very impressive. And yeah, he goes on to share some dual times, some G5 times in this video. It's literally titled Outdated Perfect Dark World Records from 14 years ago, January 2009. And I just kind of wonder why he recorded and upload. Maybe he had the video file long before and finally uploaded on YouTube or something. But yeah, interesting. It's just one of those guys who, whenever I encountered him in the community, he was not too interested in the game. And yet, you know, here I was wrong. And clearly he did have enough interest to capture his runs and upload them and so on. And it kind of makes you... it's an interesting thing in that the community was so sort of... the casual guys hanging out in that era, 05, 06, 07, who kind of had moved on from Perfect Dark or playing some other games, but them just being present, being around, upkept the website and the community for all those years. And hey, maybe without them, we wouldn't be here today. So, I know I was a bit antagonistic to those folks back in the day, but looking back now, I certainly appreciate their company and their stewardship of the community, that's for sure. Now, the next run we have to show is going to be... Okay, so it's quite a significant improvement. Times would improve rapidly, and there may or may not have been videos on a lot of these rapid improvements. So we're just going to jump ahead. You can't get stuck too far watching these old videos. We're going to go ahead and watch a 131 Special Agent, which was done... almost 2 years later, December 02. So that we're skipping ahead 2 years. This is by Greg K. I do love the VHS aesthetic on the start here. Actually you can't even really see this that well, which is interesting. So maybe we'll even skip this video here because it's a bit too insane. But hey, I love the VHS aesthetic and it certainly adds some good character to the episode. Let's see what a 131 actually does look like. 131 would become the record set by Greg K in December 02, and it would remain the world record for a couple years. And so we get this nice capture from Your Eliteness, a Special Agent 131. That'll be a much better capture. He got this in 04, so now we're kind of more into the modern-ish era. Let's see what a 131 might look like. So we got this nice NTSC footage where the top repeats on the bottom. It's cut off and repeated, so he's going right up. Now we're definitely going to see some of the strats here. I gotta think, It's coming out here. Shooting one of the guards, another one, bingo bango. So there's the chopper there, and you could destroy it. But you pick up the rocket launcher later. Oh wow, so he actually went up the lift here. That is fascinating. This is going to be NTSC, but he's in a PAL region, and so... Oh, double headshot there. That was really nice and clean. Yeah, okay, I see, exactly. So now you get the rocket launcher. You know, ideally, you'd be able to, if you had the rocket launcher earlier, he could have easily destroyed the helicopter earlier. You know, when he was face-to-face with it there. We got this nice, beautiful shots. That was really quick. You know, instead of going into the corner, that was much quicker. Bit of a back boost there, but that's life. Not a huge loss. Oh, but he did get... Oh, that hurts. He got stuck behind Cass for a... Oh, and then he choked because he got stuck. It threw him off. But he really... That was a really clean nail of that last shot, though. So that was really nice. 131. And you know, you could see 129 on that run, 128, you know, with a perfect ending. But a nice run from your eliteness there, that 131. Yeah, it's like, if he had the rocket launcher earlier, which you don't, of course, you know, let's say, you know, well, you do this, he could have shot the rocket launcher out of there, but... You know, the guys are getting so good at destroying the helicopter that, you know, again, you can see, imagine he just gets that clean shot and is running through instead of getting stuck here. You know, this is at least 3 or 4 seconds lost. Maybe the 127 would be doable in this run. You know, but he's getting so good at this shot that it kind of doesn't matter that you can't do it earlier. So that's fine. I think if you shoot it like a million times with your weapon, it does blow up. But yeah, so good stuff from your eliteness there. And if we look at the beginning of 05, we can look at the rankings. And we can see Extraction has this 130 by Boss and 139 on Perfect Agent. So Boss would even beat this with a 130, but that video has been lost to time, unfortunately. So actually has his 139 Perfect Agent, so that's very unfortunate, but you know what, that's okay, because I'm sure we'll see Boss again later on in this episode. If we look at the rankings from, you know, beginning of 05, we will see Boss's 130, we see Greg K's 131, your Elitus's 131, and D-Man 131, we see 139 140s. For some reason, Chuya Takizawa is credited with 129 at this point in time, but he never had it as a world record, and it's misdated, is all. That time is misdated, so, you know, I'm sure one of the moderators or archivists can make that correction in due time. So, hey, there you go. Interesting little screen grab there. But yeah, let's move to a run. You know, let's move to another run. I mean, it's always cool to kind of break it up and see these sort of, you know, I mean, the website is insane, right? You can go back in time and capture these, what the rankings look like on this date and time. This is a new feature, actually, to see. We could always see it, like, the whole rankings on a certain date since I've been doing lore, but to see it on a specific level, that's a relatively new feature, and so that's certainly going to help, you know, lores going ahead, and, yeah, it gives me thoughts on if I go back and redo some GoldenEye episodes or whatever, that'll be a useful thing to look at, exactly how things progress. So, in January 05, a strange gentleman, again, great aesthetic on this video, Trent, aka Hot Dog, would tie Boss's 130. And we're going to watch this run, and... yeah, it's a cool and significant run because it kind of sets the tone, I suppose, for what's going to happen next. Sometimes, you know, you wake up a bear, you know, you get someone interested in the stage again. And anyways, it's a cool run, and I love the aesthetic, and so we're going to dedicate it to our SpeedLore champion, Mr. Moxie. A huge thanks, Mr. Moxie, for your support of the SpeedLore series on Patreon. Always much appreciated. Let's enjoy this unusual run by Trent, aka Hot Dog, Extraction Special Agent. And it looks like he's going to opt for the no night vision goggles. Up the door. Here we go. Up the lift, rather. spinning around a bunch of times to stave off boredom. Understandable. Who doesn't do this? Out the lift. There we go. Nice shot there. And again, I mean, on your lead, this is 131. We certainly saw the potential of, you know, 128, 127. So even without any sort of advancements in strategies, we're going to see, we can see a few seconds get trimmed. Let's see if it gets a double pump here. Oh, yeah, that was great. This is a little bit before Alou's era. Yataraj in chat asks about Alou. A little bit before Alou's era, and I think Alou's actually never had a record on Extraction Special and Perfect Agent. He might have had one on Agent, but you know, some folks just aren't certain levels, you know? It is what it is, I would say. So he gets out before Cassandra, huge deal there. Up the stairs, and the chopper was kind of behind the X, so he didn't have a perfect angle at it, but he did eventually get it, and there is the 130, and of course the resolution's bad. That was, this is like a 2005 era thing, is like the resolution's bad, so you zoom in, and OMG, me better than YE, and I can't read, that text is illegible, but look, that's like a funny little troll there. That's kind of a very soulful, funny sort of ending to the run, right? This is the kind of, you know, people talk about the early internet compared to today. Oh, people were mean and trolling, and you know, this is the kind of trolling that went on. I think in many ways that's less offensive and less upsetting, and less dangerous than the stuff that goes on today. You know, so funny stuff by Trent there, getting that 130. And very nice run by Trent. Boss would get 129 shortly thereafter. You know, Boss oftentimes sees someone get a run and says, okay, it's time for me to do it up. And he got 129. We're not going to show that because we have some other runs that we must show instead. The last Perfect Agent run we showed, the record was 149. So this is going to be quite an improvement here from Boss. Let's take a look. And this is in his sort of mid-05 era when he became dual champion for the first time of both GoldenEye and Perfect. He had just dominated GoldenEye in 04, and then 05 he spent becoming champion in Perfect Dark, and this is from that era, so certainly an iconic era, and he's going to get some amazing world records here, especially because, you know, the record previously was 139, and this is quite an improvement. So he kind of runs against the door there. He basically, you'll see what happens there, he got out of the lift and then called the lift back. You see? And the reason he's doing that is so he doesn't go on the other lift, but now he gets on this one, opens the door, and now goes up these stairs. And this is, like, quite a bit faster than, there's the double shot, too. That whole little gambit was quite a bit faster than going up the other intentional lift. And that saved a handful of seconds, you know. So he pops over here, night vision. There we go, up the stairs. He got stuck quite severely, probably 2 seconds lost there. Nice shot. And he gets a 135, which is a good run. So that's good stuff. He did it. You know, that's 4 seconds faster than the world record here. So that's quite good. You know, quite a good time. Now again, we're seeing him improve the record, and yeah, I'll just show that once more because it is important here. He gets up on a lift, he exits the lift. Do you have to break that glass? I'm not sure if you have to break it or not. But see, he goes here, he calls, see, he's making sure that he calls the lift back up. And that way, after he clears this floor and presses B in order to complete that objective. Okay, so you don't have to break that glass. I didn't think so, but just kind of you do it for fun. Now the lift's here again. He goes on this lift. He presses B from behind to open that door, which is what we saw in the, you know, first run we watched of the night, you know, which was obviously out of order. It was, you know, a modern day, you know, beginner style run. But opening that door allows you to get up to this next floor much earlier. And so this was a significant discovery. Instead of going up the other lift, which, you know, takes... The lift's pretty slow to get all the way up and stop and then get on and slowly go up. And you would have to kind of... Yeah, so it saved a bunch of time and you got 135, which is great. Now, here's a question for you all. Definitely. JD Black says, one of Boss's classic swag strats. I couldn't agree more. Now, let's say, in theory, you were fast enough where you didn't have to do this little thing. You could, let's say you just pressed B right now to open this door. And, you know, the door closes after a handful of seconds. But let's say you opened the door from behind, ran off, did all this, and got back before the door even closed, avoiding you from having to go back on the lift. You know, this would save a huge amount of time. He saved 4 seconds over the world record by doing it this way. If you could get through that door, if it was still open coming back, this would save way more time, you know. And my friends, we would find out just how much time it would save on his next run, which he would post on the same day, August 14, 2005. And this, my friends, is a truly historic and remarkable run. So remarkable and wonderful, in fact, that we must dedicate it to a speedlore champion. And this one goes out to our good pal FC Bojangles. A huge thanks, FC, for your support of speedlore on Patreon. Let's watch this remarkable and truly historic run by Boss, Extraction Special Agent. You know, it's easier to make the door cycle on Special Agent because you don't have to go all the way into that one room to press B to activate the lift as an objective. So here we go, going up here. Gonna press B from behind the door. So you could hear it. He opened the door, now he's rushing through. It's gonna be intense. One guard, two guard. Oh, that was, look how quick of a shot he had to do there. And is he gonna make the door cycle? you could see the door closing, but he made it. So now, like, you can just imagine how much time this has saved compared to the, you know, previous iteration. And again, the 135 was a cut from 139 on Perfect Agent. He kind of got stuck there. This is Special Agent, where the record is 129, his own untied. So how much will he lower that 129 by, where he was, you know, going up the lift the old style way? I mean, it even just looks faster, you know? He makes a good escape here from Cassandra. He does kind of have to wait for the chopper to... But look, 122, baby. A 7-second untied. He literally untied the stage by 7 full seconds, which is pretty insane, you know? And, yeah. Yeah, so we can kind of see that at this pace, the rocket's kind of becoming a problem because the chopper is, like, always behind this X. So you have to, like, wait around and then shoot it. Oh, yeah, and the rocket almost missed. Like, he look, it hits the tail. So that could have failed and he would have choked the run. But yeah, if you listen for it close, you can listen to him open the door here. That second sort of shift. That one. And then he barely gets back in time. It's pretty impressive. Shoots there. You have to pass away those three guards because it's an objective as well. And then listen close. You could hear it starting to close as he barely made it through. So extremely impressive stuff. So now we see here, and again, Chuya Takizawa's time was not achieved in 2005. That's a mistake. So Boss had an 8-second untied. He had cut his own record 7 seconds, but now he was 8 seconds over second place and 5 on Perfect Agent. So that's, like, very impressive, you know, like, just Boss things. And, you know, to be fair, we know Ace would come along and do similar things in the game in due time, but, you know, to get an 8-second untied in 05 was remarkable and shocking. People were shocked, frankly. It sort of was emblematic of Boss's reign as simply the best player in the game in that era, which he certainly was. But of course, not all things, you know, all things, you know, sometimes don't always last. You know, I'm trying to put it one way or another. Over the years, other players would come along and get good and get decent at the game. It would, in fact, be 2 full years later when the Japanese speedrunner Taka would come along and he would make a run for champion and he would actually tie Boss's 135 on Perfect Agent. You know, Taka is, you know, some of these Japanese runners have kind of come back to the community, and it was, you know, like, honestly, it was a bit hard to communicate with them back then, obviously, language barrier, 07, you know, it's a bit tough. But now, you know, with the ease of translation tools, it's a lot easier to communicate with these guys. And so Taka tweets a lot about the game. And it's always kind of nice to see Taka tweeting about it, and you can kind of understand each other better now and exchange messages. And so it's nice to have Taka around in the community again. He kind of stepped away for a long time. But yeah, he's back now, and we get to celebrate this run. You know, they're opening the door again. There we go. 15 years later, you know, 15 and a half years later. So that's pretty cool. Nice shot. Oh, he didn't get the double hit there. So he had to stop and reload a second time. You know, you wonder if he was able to get the double pump shotgun shot on both guards there. Maybe he would have got 134 or 133 on this run. But, oh, he's going to go for the light switch. That's what I'm... And look, they get stunned. I'm actually really happy that we get to see a light switch run. So I guess that was the strategy he liked. And you know what, to be fair, might be just as good or just as fast, because you'll have to, like, pause and sort of toggle, you know, a sort of weird view. Nice shot. Again, hit the edge. And we got that 135 by Taka. So a great run. And a huge congrats to him. You know, that's cool. And, was he kind of careful there at some point? Oh yeah, so he missed the double pump. That was one. And the ending was, like, a little bit careful, I guess. You know, so again, we can see great run. You know, he slayed a 2-year-old untied world record that was untied by 4 seconds when set. But lower's possible. And my friends, who do we think would come along and go for lower? You know, let's think about it. We're in 07. Late 07. Ace finally is sent in NTSC console from his pals in Europe, Carathorn and Red Bull, who earned $150 playing online poker and sent him a PAL NTSC console. It's kind of funny that Europeans ended up sending him an NTSC console because, you know, it's the North American version, but hey, they were the nice guys who did it and helped create insane amounts of history. You know, especially in December 07, Ace had been kind of playing, you know, for about 2 years, proving himself. You know, he had so many doubters early on, but now he's ready to shock the world. Like, you know, he got like some like 25 untieds in December 07 in Perfect Dark when he got this NTSC console. And so, hey, the record is 135 by Boston Taka. Ace says, I'm going to attempt playing this level myself and see what I can get. He is 12 years old at the time. And, well, here we go. A run so remarkable that it can simply be dedicated to a Speedlore champion, 4-Day Bender, our pal. A huge thanks, 4-Day, for supporting Speedlore on Patreon. Much appreciated. Try to predict, my friends, the time that Ace gets on this remarkable stage. Actually, the capture quality is making me wonder if this was actually done on PAL. I'm going to double check this here. Okay, no, this was NTSC, just as I suspected. Wow, he has a crazy PR history on the stage. So that's interesting. I wonder why he peeks out there. I don't know why he peeks out there and then calls back the lift. I'm sure he's just wasting the same amount of time as, you know, Taka and Boss were. You probably have to wait a bit to recall the lift, but that's, here he goes, he's on the lift, opens the door from behind. It's locked from the front, by the way, that's why you do this. Up here, pump. Oh, he misses the double pump too. I mean, I was not expecting that. But, you know, he is Ace, every movement is cleaner, everything is insane. He simply has a God-given gift for these games. So see, he's not going to go for the light switch. He's going to turn on night vision. Man, he took 2 shotgun blasts. And like, that was definitely faster than Taka's, you know, method. Not to say it was bad or anything, but you know, this was faster, no doubt. And up, bingo, bango. Oh, and before the X. Ace hits the chopper before the X, and we get a 132, a 3-second untied world record, which is a very, very epic and remarkable. What can you say? Just Ace getting 3-second untieds, you know? There's few things you can say at a time like that. Okay. Well, if you thought that was something, and it was, you know, I mean, you could imagine if he does manage to hit a double headshot there, 131, 130s on the table, you know? But it was still a very good run, and he had just great movement all around, you know? Like, you can imagine just YOLO headshotting them all without even putting the night vision on, but, like, that is probably a 2020 technique as opposed to 2007, you know. He gets up here quick, doesn't get stuck, and the rocket shot at the end is so nice, too. Like, hitting it before the big X at the top of the building, really nice. So, yeah, 132. And, yeah, if you thought that was something, my friends, wait to see what he does on Special Agent. Also from December 07. There it really is. Big Tommy Manson. There's so much soul in this video, it almost hurts, and I agree. Nice shot. Nice shot. Again, you really YOLO this over and over. Like, you'd reset a ton there. He makes the door, kind of warps, like, it's kind of closing on him, and he warps through. Oh my god, he misses the double headshot again. I mean, it's really hard to do, no doubt, but again, we're watching, you know, world record runs as we do in a speedlore episode, so I'm kind of surprised that he's missing these double headshots. So he is more YOLOing this on Special Agent, the lower difficulty. You can afford to take more shots, which helps the ability to YOLO it. You know, he shot two guards before turning on the night vision, and now he's up, and wow, bang. We've got Extraction Special Agent 120. So he's now set run so good. We've got 120 SA, 132 PA, and that is where things stand now. And again, these were in December 07. They were untied for two full years into 2010. 120 SA, 132 PA. And we can see the rankings are full of, you know, Taka's got records. This Toth record is super rare up here. You know, I don't want to get sidetracked on these other stages. You know, Clemens is starting to play Perfect Dark and getting a lot of world records. If Clemens decides to play a stage, he's probably going to get the world record. Shout out to the Dennis Lucid record here. That is so legendary. Man, I mean, these rankings are like a throwback. We had Funky Buddha down here on his specialty stages. Attack ship Red Bull. Red Bull's one of the guys who sent the console to Ace. You know, so a lot of really cool stuff to go through. But yeah, the key for this episode is 120, 132 by Perfect Ace. Very remarkable runs. And we can see again, the 120 is untied by 2 seconds. Taka has 127 now, which is good. Ace's 132 is untied by 3 seconds. So remarkable stuff. At this point in Perfect Dark history. So here we are in the early 2010 year, a crazy and wonderful time on the internet, all things considered. And of course now our pal True Faith Clem is playing some Perfect Dark. Unfortunately, I'll mute that music there, but you know, hey, it is what it is. We'll we'll commentate the run just as well. And, of course, we saw that Ace had remarkable runs of 120 on Special Agent and 132 on Perfect Agent. And so a question, I guess, is this one's Special Agent. So we can assume Clem is going to, you know, hit the door cycle here because he's a very good player. But a question does arise, like, will anyone ever hit that door cycle on Perfect Agent? You have to go deeper into that room. I mean, look how tight this is. Like, it would be insane to hit that cycle on Perfect Agent. You know, look, the door, he barely makes the door on Special Agent, and on Perfect, you have to go deeper into the room. So will that be a thing that happens? Oh man, he also, no one's hit the double pump. He almost looked like he missed that guard too on the second comeback, but obviously he did. You know, it's hard to tell in Perfect Dark sometimes with the animations. There's a shot. There's a shot, pause for the night vision as it comes on. Bingo bango, switches to shotgun, blasts her up the stairs, takes off night vision, through the door. I mean, this is a really good run. I don't see any mistakes. That was a great run, dude. 120. So Clem comes in there and clutches out the 120 Special Agent. And so you have to imagine, that the 132 is maybe going to be in the crosshairs at some point. Somehow, some way, 4 days after tying the 120 SA, Clem got this run on Special Agent. This run is shocking, my friends. It's Against Special Agent again. Will he dupe 120? You know, what can it be? Looking up there, you do wonder about lag going up the elevator, if any, like, looking direction is going to help or not help, but let's see. Okay, so he... Oh my god, he almost got stuck there a little bit. But he was doing a new technique of getting both guards on the way in, and then... Oh my god, he barely makes the door. Oh, you know what? He's going to hit the double pump. Same run, but he's going to hit the double pump. Wow. Okay, so there's your time save. There's a sort of, like, the modern technique is kind of going, like, get the rocket launcher kind of pull back a bit from the door instead of getting, you know, risk getting stuck, to avoid getting stuck. Super clean. He's here. He's at the door. He got pumped in the face by that guard, but he's here. Up. You can get stuck here, which is tough. Nails the shot. Bingo, bango, bongo, baby. What time is it? Who's going to watch this? Seems to be some sort of New Order remix he's playing. Amazing run, right? That was faster. The double pump. The first time we've seen a successful double pump since, like, the early records by, like, West and Infill, you know, which is remarkable. Here we go, baby. This is shocking and stunning. My mind is blown. Oh my god, Trent, or Mr. Blonde really accosts Cassandra there. 118. A 2 second untied. Yeah, that's amazing. That's truly amazing and shocking. And, I mean, what more can you say? Yeah, I can't marinate on it for too long, because obviously now, you know, he's untied, Special Agent, by 2 seconds. He's got to play Perfect Agent. And 4 days later, January 19th, 2010, he would get this run on Perfect Agent. Again, not even bothering to pass away guards here. The first few. You want to get a couple because you need ammo. Look, Dr. Carroll's under attack. Dr. Carroll can pass away, and sometimes it can be really frustrating. You'll play the start of the level over and over again and get, like, really bad luck, and Dr. Carroll passes away all the time, or, you know, it happens. You can imagine a run where he passes away here on a good pace. So again, Clem's gonna call the lift. You have to wait for it to go down a certain amount, and then you can call it. And obviously, as time goes on, you know, you get better and better at figuring out exactly when the best time to do that is. Nice blast. Be there. Nice blast. Really clean strafe transition there. And here we go. Gonna go door up. Let's see. Is he gonna have the double blast here? I mean, imagine grinding all these runs for the double blast. He gets it. Didn't pause buffer it. Most guys today would pause buffer it, but he didn't pause buffer it. He's up. Oh my dear, this is insane. Let's see. Oh my god, almost. Can you imagine? He literally was, like, one shot from passing away, and still is. You know, he could easily pass away still. Like, he got... Oh, look, he took a second there, because he was so nervous. He took a second, and as a result is behind Cass. Because he knew, like, he had to wait to not get hit and pass away. And yet still, 1:31 PA, new untied world record by 1 second. Amazing, amazing stuff by Clem there. Yep, truly and utterly remarkable. And his pair of records here, I'm gonna jump in on the time here. So if we go to February 1st, 2010, this is 13 years ago, we see he has the untied sweep on extraction, which is pretty sick. Like, he was mostly a GoldenEye player at this point. But he would come to Perfect Dark and achieve anything he wanted to achieve. And if we skip ahead 3 years in time, almost, January 1st, 2013, his 118 and 131 are still untied. So they'd remain untied for 3 full years, which is insane. Like, absolutely insane. And, you know, we can see, we can fully see, like, he was so close if he had more health, and he could have tanked a shotgun shot from the guard here. Like, that cost him at least 1.5, 2 seconds. And so something like 129, 128, and he gets stuck behind Cass a little bit. So I would say 128 is probably on the table. Yet, I think the fact that this remained untied for 3 full years shows just how daunting of a time this is. I mean, it's hard to survive. It's hard to hit the cycle. It's hard to hit the headshots. It's a very hard stage. Obviously, that always goes a little bit underappreciated when doing lores, because we're just kind of flying through all the world record history. But amazing run, and yeah, 131, untied for 3 years. Who do you think lowered or tied the 131? My friends, it was none other than True Faith himself. In this glorious era, January 2013, the 30th of the month, to be precise. You know, I used to resent this footage, but over time I've come to love it. The CRT webcam capture. True Faith would get a run so remarkable that it would go down in history. And not only that, I mean, wow, there's more to it than that, as we'll see. A run so remarkable that it is simply dedicated to our SpeedLore champion, Sewell O'Rock. A huge thanks to our pal Sewell for your support of SpeedLore on Patreon. Let's take a look, baby. We're probably gonna get Clem's like ambient celebration and sounds, which is epic. It's kind of funny because the video footage is actually like more clear than some of the captured stuff we've seen. I think it is exactly similar to the Control Agent 356 quality red screens mentions in chat. Oh my god. He waits probably till now to press B. And like, there's probably times when you pressed B a frame or two early, the lift didn't get called back up, and you successfully did all this in good speed, and the lift wasn't there, which must be very frustrating. But the lift's there, a guard is in the way. The classic, my friends, the classic. I'm gonna leave that in because it's epic. He's up the lift. It's kind of funny how, like, that's an objective. Like, it's such like a kind of a throwaway objective, like, oh, get on this elevator, but I guess it does help guide you through the stage somewhat. So just after it passes kind of the second, like, one floor down, you call it again. Press B. And I mean, hitting B there is no easy task either, you know? Like, these runs are cooked. There's the lift. Opens the door. Oh my god. I can't believe it. His 131 is still untied. Oh my god, he missed the double headshot. Probably cost like 1.5 seconds, honestly. But he probably lost 1.5 to 2 seconds. Maybe 3. By being more cautious with the guard at the end there. So let's take a look, see what he does here. Let's see what he pulls off. Oh my god. The big blast. He knows it could be the run. Up, up. Before the X. Oh my god. Wow. No celebration hardly. And he actually probably lost another second at the end because the level didn't unspawn right away because he missed stepping on the center X up like there's a particular spot you have to stand up here right in the middle of the table for it to fade out, but he like overran it before he hit it and to come back. He may have lost a second there. Maybe it wasn't a full second, so maybe that didn't cost him 128, but all in all, the double headshot miss and that definitely 128, maybe even 127. So insane, insane stuff. Now, I mean, there's just so many cooked facts about these Clem runs here on Extraction. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot to take in, and we will take in a lot of that as we go. This run remained untied for another 3 years. Like, how insane is that? So, to put in perspective, he gets 118, 131 in 2010, lowers the 131 in 2013 to this, 129. 118 still untied. Now we're going to go into one, we're going to go to the year 2016. So 6 years after he first graced the stage. 6 years later. And my friends, who is the next person to tie or lower a record on Extraction? Well, once again in 2016, it is True Faith Clem himself. Knowing that there was some time left on the table back in 2013, he goes back to Extraction Perfect Agent and plays for lower and gets a run so remarkable, we must dedicate it to our SpeedLore champion, Sammy Limex. A huge thanks, Sammy, for your support of SpeedLore on Patreon. Let's watch this thing of beauty. Again. It's amazing, guys. I mean, it is true. These the quitouts sort of always watching someone on stream. The quitouts help show you like what actually doing attempts is like, you know? He's on.
Dude, these starts. Like, every run is so fast today. I'm playing so well. My movement is, like, really, really good today. Just gotta get lucky. That's all.
I Red Springs asks if Clem's ever ripped his shirt off after a time. I'm not sure. I don't think so. He's flexed, but I'm not sure he's ripped his shirt. Oh my god, he got the double headshot. Oh my god, he's up. This is a great run. Oh, I could see her night vision goggles there, actually. Now that I'm looking for it. Oh my god, barely got the headshot. Oh my god.
Come on, dude. Get through.
Y- Yeah, you can get stuck on Cassandra there. Like, almost every run, there's, like, a chance you'll get stuck on Cassandra after the perfect run. That could happen every time tonight, you know?
Okay. I did it! Oh my god, dude. That ending was fucking awful. Holy shit. Wow.
You know, it was an insane run. But, like he says, he's still not satisfied with the... I mean, it makes you wonder, like, what is possible on this stage? Because... if he doesn't love the ending, you know, he kind of got stuck on Cass. He did get through, but he kind of got stuck. You know, let's say that's 127, 126. And then, you know, imagine you hit the same lift cycle that we're hitting on Special Agent. Like, what is possible on Perfect Age on the stage? You know, we're at 128 now. It really makes you wonder. But for now, yeah, Clem has... now had the untied on the stage for 6 years straight between three different untieds, and that's just an impressive reign. Like, very rare for that kind of thing to happen. Like, you lower a stage after 3 years before anyone else ties it, and you do that exact same thing twice in a row, you know, for a period of 6 years. It's so impressive. Like, you know, it becomes more remarkable looking at this stuff all these years later, viewing it through the lens of more of like a conventional career that these speedrunners have in these games, similar to, you know, the career of a you know, professional athlete or an artist or something. You know, you have these arcs and these storylines over years, and it gives it that much more depth, which I think is really cool, as we see Clem, you know, laughing hysterically about his 128 there. So that's cool. Now, Boss, a year later, we get 129. It's an interesting 129 because, well, this run is proof. You can take it safe throughout the level with the Special Agent Door Strat. Bled away too much time in the end. Good luck to anyone trying to get a run with this. Nerves were pretty intense. Probably as intense as Surface 2 Double Off getting two nades. I mean, that sounds crazy. But let's watch Boss's 129. Because he does pull off the Special Agent Door cycle. But he does, there's a little twist to it that makes it more viable. He kind of thinks, okay, if I play the level relatively safe, but just go for a completely YOLO, you know, first elevator level and make the lift cycle, let's see what time I can get. And he almost tied Clem's 128, which is pretty cool. So there he's going for it. Let's see him YOLO this. Oh, he does them both on the way back. Oh my god, he barely warp squeezed through. That was insane. That was absolutely nuts. Good morning to Sula Rock in chat. Sewell, I regret to inform you that your dedication run was moments ago, but I'm sure you'll see it on rewatch. It was a dandy too, baby. And we've got some good runs cooking tonight here on Extraction, Perfect, and Special Agent. So he cut, you know, a lot of pause buffering, taking it a lot slower there. You know, he's got the run of a lifetime, you know? He's made the lift cycle, made the door cycle. That might as well have been hitting a depot warp. Yeah, it was pretty insane, JD. I was going to go over here. I'm going to try to compare TTs. Actually, I'm going to, well, maybe towards the end of the episode we can do that. Because I don't know if the TTs will be visible on, like, Clem's runs. That's the thing. Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. You have to clutch so much at the end. I mean, once again, in the lore episodes, you don't get an appreciation for it. Like, imagine getting the run of your lifetime, and then still having to nail this, like, very tricky, oh my god, very tricky rocket launcher shot. That was just so unfortunate. 129.35, almost got the 128. That's funny. Kumik says the name of the rocket launcher in Japanese is just R launcher. That might have just been like how it displayed on screen, but maybe not, you know, so it is kind of cute. Look at them blasting you away here. Oh my dear. And then Cassandra gets roughed up by Mr. Blonde. It's not very nice or appropriate. I can see why the game was rated mature, you know? I mean, he was probably very much ahead of Clem's 128 pace at this point, but then took things really slow. You know, way ahead. You're like 5 seconds ahead at this point. Oh my god. So what he did actually here... He opens the door from behind, then closes it, and then opens it again. And the way you're able to... what that does is the door opens, and then you close it, and then when you reopen it a second time, it still like finishes closing a bit, and there's a bit of a buffer moment where it has to reopen. And actually, shoutouts to the Rixer for pointing this out. This is well known in today's attempts of this level, but Ricky pointed out in the SpeedLore thread in the forum, which is much appreciated. It is something that helps you make the cycle on Perfect Agent. It gives you about a third of a second more. Still not that much to work with, but just enough. Yeah, exactly. So you open it, you close it, and then you reopen it, but the momentum of the door like still closes it before reopening it again. And you can mistime it and actually cost yourself, you know, you can give yourself less time to make the door cycle. But ideally, it'll give you about a third, 0.3 more to get through the crack. And obviously, Boss needed that because we can see how he, you know, barely squeezed through. And then he just, you know, he played the rest level pretty safe and slow. And that's why he got 129.35. And he kind of got screwed, like, getting stuck on Cass alone. If he didn't get stuck on Cass, he would have got... I mean, that was painful. He would have got 128, maybe 127. And so, I mean, yeah, with this technique now on the table, you're talking 124, maybe lower. And so it's amazing stuff. Keep in mind, Clemens's runs are still untied. Who will come along and tie them? Well, there was this brief era around 2017 when a French speedrunner by the name of Grinounet came along. And Grinounet was a very good speedrunner, and he still is if he plays not as much these days. But Grinounet went out there and decided he wanted to get some of these world records. And so he's playing Special Agent here, trying to tie Boss's, or rather, trying to try Clem's 118 Special Agent. Let's take a look and see what he gets. Oh my god, he hit both. Oh, he's... Oh my... He realizes he missed it. That was insane. Makes the cycle. He's gotta get the double pump here. I'd be stunned if he doesn't. But yeah, now he's got the double pump, but now, you know, we're in the pause buffering era. Which, you know, some people find a little bit less aesthetically pleasing. You know, it is what it is. But certainly helps you at those moments, you know, when you're not running full speed. It can certainly help you execute a tough strategy. Nails the run, looking good. The R launcher, baby. He... Oh my dear, 118.76. I think that last pause buffer was to get rid of the lag. I wonder what the timer on screen is about, actually. I don't know what that timer on screen was. If it's like a relic or an objective or something. This run was actually hoarded in... K3, Kapap 3. It was hoarded in Kapap 3, and so this was done in May 2017, but it was not revealed until October 2017 in Kapap 3. Oh, that's right, Kumik. Kumik points out that the timer is a relic from the lights being off when you're fighting the guards, because they do automatically come back on. Yeah, Joanna's model is different in the Japanese version, Crest. She looks, you know, a little bit more... regional. She looks different face, different hairstyle. So that's epic. So this was posted in October, done in May. As we can see here, Clem's Extraction Special Agent 118 is the third longest standing untied ever in Perfect Dark history. It stood untied for... Man, these Perfect Dark untieds are insane. It was 7.5 years untied. Like, that's just nonsensical. You know, 7.5 years untied. Wow. Wow. Remarkable stuff. So, that shows you how good that 118 is. A remarkable run. Epic run. And, yeah. Way to go to Clem and Green for those remarkable speedruns. Green would play Perfect Agent. This was also hoarded in Kapap 3. It is a remarkable run. Let's just sit back and enjoy it. So we see still, he's not going for the technique that Boss proved was possible, getting the insane, you know, sequence there. Opens the door.
The music glitch.
It is interesting how he turns off auto-aim there and goes for headshots. I guess, like, all in all, that is more consistent, and it's more consistently fast than doing the double pump attempt. You probably get more runs completed, and it's, like, you know, only mildly slower. a shot. Oh man, he missed the first pump there. That was like
bait.
That was lucky to catch it back.
It was a dice note up. Might beat. Something I can do for you, old woman. Yes. Just in time. You don't know what you're I don't know what is it. 127? Oh, that would be sick. One more chance. Give it back. And you could come and work for me. Shit. If I had my phone I would have snapped the hell out of it. Our low on 28, yeah. We cannot proceed without it. I know that. So it's a world record. I also holy shit. Know who to talk to, Mr. Carrington. Oh shit, yes! An extraction untied by Greenune in 2017. Wow. Let's keep. Thanks. Thanks, guys.
So that was pretty epic, the 127 by Greenunet. Now, it seems like he is responding to people in chat, and indeed, this one was live streamed. It is interesting that he was hoarding the one on Special Agent. But, you know, obviously his skills were fine-tuned, and so he achieved this one live while hoarding the 118. And so it kind of always creates interesting... People are kind of probably asking, oh, when are you going to go for 118? Yeah, he was playing great, and, you know, good techniques using the auto-aim off to headshot the bodyguards there and so on, and just a great run. Now, after Kapap 3 came out, you know, it was the first unhoard where there was untied world records. Luke's Aztec 00135, and Green actually had one. I think it was like Investigation PA or something. I think that's right. So, in the, you know, afterglow of Kapap 3, Green's feeling pretty good about himself. And, well, let's watch this bad boy. The 117 end screen. Oh, looks like we're gonna get the double version. It's always nice to see a double version. Music version plus, you know, clean audio. So let's take a look at his 117. You know, again, very impressive. You know, Green, again, doesn't have the, you know, longevity in the community like a Clem or a Boss or an Ace or myself or a Lou or so on. And it might be for the best. You know, maybe it's a better idea to only be involved in a speedrunning online community for like 2 or 3 or 4 years, you know, and not 15. In his time where he played, he got some great world records. And I think certainly his pair of extraction and tides are probably at the top of his achievements in the game. You know, he makes that with good time to spare. Looks like he's going to go for the double pump on Special Agent. You know, why not? Oh, yeah, he also untied Bunker 200, 54, which was a great untied. And that lasted until the Arlene warp was found. So that's a great run, too. You know, so... great player, set some great runs, and you know, what strikes me, I this isn't necessarily about green per se, but about, you know, there's the quote, you know, you either die a hero or live long enough to see yourself as the villain, right? And so if you just come in and play for a couple of years and get some great world records, you know, you're almost always going to be remembered as a hero type. So certainly probably is a better technique to play and speedrun that way.
One more chance. Give it back. And you could come and work for me. Sorry, gotta shoot.
You must get the sapient back. We can. I find it interesting how the voice acting is English, even though the version is Japanese. I wonder if there's any toggle for that. I kind of doubt it in a game this old. That's just a kind of minutia that I don't actually know the answer to. I know on the PAL version you can set the language to French, German, Italian, and Spanish, I believe. But yeah, there's just too many voice lines, and it would have been too insane to do at this point in gaming history. But yeah, it's kind of interesting. Now I have some Twitch clips to show. This is always a fun part of the night before getting to the final stretch of world records. This is a clip from Green from 5 years ago. So this was during his untied attempts.
Yep. Really? Ah. Hey, Luke.
Really? Hey, Luke. He missed punching the guard there. He missed punching the, you know... But he got the rocket launcher, so, you know, I'm not entirely sure exactly what he missed. There might be a key card or something you need there. You know, I apologize. I haven't played this level in ages, but, you know, it is what it is. There's something that, you know, he missed the punch on the guard, that's for sure. Cost him a run where he was able to get the double shot. Oh, he had no ammo! Oh, that's what it was, Flicker. That's really funny. He has 10 shotgun bullets, but no.
Really?
No P150 ammo. Unfortunate. Here's another clip, Extraction PA. Let's take a look. So Cassandra got in the way of his blast there. She has a shield, which can't be penetrated, and so you don't hit the guard.
Really?
His really is funny. And then, well, look, my friends. Clem is back at Extraction. I guess he hasn't taken a liking to Green getting his records, and so Clem wants him back. This clip is called Jimbo Plays Extraction SA, though, so maybe it's not a successful clip. Let's take a look. We meet again, Joe. Wow, no night vision. So that was a 118 dupe. I guess his stream title was probably Jimbo Plays Extraction SA as a joke. Obviously, Clem is very good. And yeah, that was close because we can see in the in the bottom left, the timer is like 117.7. So it was a super low 118 dupe. But hey, it is what it is. That's part of the game. Clem would carry on playing. And on January 1st, 2018, Clem would indeed get a run. A run so remarkable, it is dedicated to our final speedlore champion of the night, our pal E Street A huge thanks to East Street for your support of SpeedLore on Patreon. Let's take a look, baby.
These fuckers are not dying the way they should be.
Nice shots. Got them both. Yeah, he's low on ammo. I see. I mean, that's another factor that I hadn't even really considered too much or given too much attention to. It's like, you can run out of ammo. There's so many things that can go wrong. I mean, look, that double headshot went right, though. That's for sure. Gets the ammo. Gets the rocket. That was a super fast, you know, getting in the door there. Oh my god, he's going YOLO, no pausing. You know, I alluded to that being possible earlier, and it's amazing to see it actually kind of happen.
Yes! 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 What? Oh, I thought that was 116. God damn it. Whatever. That was disappointing.
That is simply such a classic Clemens moment. Exactly. JD Black says classic Clemens reaction, and it so is. But he got the 1-1-17 tied, which is a very good run regardless. And yeah, he knew he's, you know, 116's out there. Let's see, if I go to this point in time, let's type in 2018 and the second day, and so here we are, you know, 117, 127 are the world records on the stage. When do you get this? Am I a year off? Huh. Whatever, the date isn't coming up. But Clem, at this point in time, early 2018, has 117 tied, and 127 00 is still the world record untied. So that's pretty good stuff. And hey, that is, in a way, the story of Extraction, Essay, and Perfect Agent. But we haven't seen our pal Ace back in action yet. What do we think Ace does? Well, at some point, Ace gets invited into the Project 2020 Unhorde, and they want to make that Horde have the most untieds of any Horde ever, which they successfully do. Callie was in there with some untieds and a few others, but also Ace got like 11 untieds. This was one of them. It's Extraction, Special Agent. Let's take a look. Remember, the records are 117, 127 before Ace gets involved. Opens the door. Nice shots. It seems like sometimes they don't get that. See, he shot again in case he didn't fully finish off that second guard there. And that seems to be a good technique. The movement there's tough. Like, it's, again, these speed lures, you know, you see all the beautiful, amazing runs. And not the, you know, all, everything in between, which is the majority of stuff. I mean, this run is just, you know, it looks robotic, it looks divine. the two rarely mix, divinity and roboticness. But Ace can blend them perfectly. I mean, the movement there is better than anything we've seen tonight. So that, like, sums it up. Like, what else can you say? Just the casual 116. Like, that's literally all there is to it. So that was unhoarded in Project 2020. It was achieved in late 2019. Now, here's the thing. Again, just after Project 2020 is unhoarded and his 116 is revealed, Ace decides, you know what? I actually haven't played Perfect Agent in a long time. Okay, I haven't played Perfect Agent in a long time. Why do I not try to play Perfect Agent? You know, why not? Well, the world record is 127. Now remember this. Only Boss has pulled off the door open strategy on Perfect Agent. Because again, you have to run further into the room. On Special Agent, we see them backing up now as they shoot that third bodyguard. So the record's 127. Boss has shown you can get through the crack on Perfect Agent. Do we think Ace can do it? I guess we'll find out. This is from July 2020. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, that's true. This was also in the era of, you know, 2020, where the world was very silly for a long time. And Ace was speedrunning a lot. I think he was, you know, he was in limbo. He was trying to, you know, get into a master's program, but, you know, things were sidelined for a while there in 2020. So he was deciding, let's just play Perfect Dark. Let's just do what they do best. Insane. Can he make the lift? He had free time on his hands to grind these insane stages and makes the crack. Makes the crack. Now, he's Ace. So, we can assume he is not going to play it super safe. He's going to play it super fast. Nice headshots. He's going to turn on the auto aim again. Now, what sort of world class time do we think is possible on Perfect Agent with getting the door cycle and a really good ending? So he does go night vision. Oh my god, headshot. Headshot. Took him three shots, but it's still insane. Double blast. He knows it's the run. Cassandra trolls him. Oh my god. Even with the slight Cassandra troll, what do we think we got here? And the X troll. Just your casual 5-second untied world record, 122 Perfect Agent. And it's kind of remarkable and poetic as well, because the first great Special Agent record of Boss back in 05 was 122, the first big cut with the hitting the door cycle, you know? So it kind of comes full circle on that, you know, getting the 122 Perfect Agent. Pretty amazing. Well, you guys know Ace. You know what he can be like. I guess he decided, you know, actually, sorry, that one was in February 2020. But still, by July 2020, things were still strange in the world. And I guess Ace decided, you know what? On that run, I missed a few headshots. And not only did I miss a few headshots, but I also, you know, got stuck behind Cassandra a little bit. Is lower possible? And so this one is in July 2020. Ace decides, can I do it again? Can I get, you know, that 122, can I tidy it up? Second place is still, you know, 127. Can he beat 122? Let's take a look. Ace told me at this point he was so fast he was not doing the like opening, closing, and reopening trick there. And it's, that's what he told me. So he doesn't go for the early shot, just goes for one headshot. That was definitely better than last time. Gets one shot there, two shots, while the other guard is kind of like not there yet, which is kind of troll. Oh, they were clumped up together. He believes he has both of them. Took like five shots though, which is kind of annoying. Ammo, rocket launcher. He's going with the Falcon here. Nice headshot. Second headshot. Night vision. Oh, missed. Missed two. Got the third. Nice, that was clean. Here we go. Let's see if he gets stuck on Cass. Oh, no way. No stuck at all, baby. This is clean. Can he hit the early rocket shot before the X? Extraction Perfect Agent 119. 8 seconds ahead of second place. Simply truly remarkable. Few other words are able to describe such a thing. Yeah, and if you look at Ace's like PR history on the stage, you know, he cut the level from... He cut it from 132, which was his old world record, down to 122. So he cut 10 seconds off, and then three more here for 119. Bingo, bango, bongo. Yeah, and so what's interesting, that's a great point, Sulo Rock. Closing the gap between Special Agent and Perfect Agent. It's only 3 seconds now. You know, previously it was like 10 seconds. Green Hornet had 127, 117. 10 seconds. Now we're at 3 seconds. So, naturally, Ace decides, well, I have to go and play Special Agent now. Here's a run. I guess I clipped it. I don't really remember clipping it. Helicopter fails strangely and unusually.
Let's see if it falls in the same manner it did in the previous run. I found it. Holy shit, dude. It flew, like, towards me. That was kind of cool.
And it's super laggy. Yeah, I don't know what explains that weird fall, but it was strange. Anyways, it sounds, you know, there's... We're going to show two more runs, and then we're going to, like, briefly talk about some potential strangeness on the stage. And then, hey, that's it, baby. But, you know, what do you expect? Ace decides, okay, I gotta lower Special Agent now. November and December 2021. At this point, yeah, I see. He's you know, started, you know, he's got some free time on his hands still. You know, he's getting comfortable. He's chilling. The world is still not quite back in order, but, you know, it is what it is. And, here we go. You imagine on Special Agent now, it's pretty cake for him to make this cycle. Yeah, no doubt. He's in there, baby. Oh, he's going with the shotgun on Special Agent. Full speed. Oh, my dear. Oh, that was a little bit... That was a little bit more insane than I was expecting, if I'm going to be honest. my dear. $114.95. It's sadly rounded up to a $115. So, yeah, he was so early on the helicopter up to the top, he was so fast at the end, that at the ramp he had to compensate and aim a little bit to the left, as Kumik points out here. He could have shot there, which would be really insane. Probably maybe slower, but, you know, just a theoretical idea. 115, obviously he's not keen that it was a 114.95, so a week later he kept playing and said it's time to get the actual 114, at least get one frame faster and have it save as 114. And so that is exactly what he did. That is the final run of the night, and that is where the world records currently stand. 114 special agent, 119 perfect agent, and Ace got 47 agent, which was untied as well. And I believe it's still, he had the untied sweep if he does not still. We're going to take a look at the rankings in a second. Yeah, just a, like, sort of full speed, double shotgun blast on this on the next floor is just beyond insane. Right through, not even a problem anymore. Blast away, gain the full speed, double. That was legitimately full speed. That was not even like he didn't even stop or let off. That was legitimately full speed, double shotgun blast on those two guards. Like, I gotta think this is as good as you can possibly play this level. You know, 114.68. How can you do any better than that? Just the perfect run. If we look at the world rankings, we'll see that, so Alluring Fairy has some good times. 116 special agent, 125 perfect agent. He's untied second in both cases. Ace does have 47 untied on agent, untied sweep, no doubt. 6 seconds on perfect agent, 2 on special, 1 on agent. It's just truly remarkable. Like, 2 untied sweeps in a row, even on the rankings. G5 untied sweep, so 3 untied sweeps there. It's truly remarkable. What more can you possibly say? You know, yeah, Alluring Fairy may attempt to tie these, and he is very good, and maybe he will. But who knows? Only time will tell, my friends, and that's always the best part of speed lore, is that only time will tell what the future has to behold. And if there's one last thought on what might happen, there's a couple videos here from Henrik, you know, the TAS master. So there is a theoretical strategy where you can clip out of bounds and shoot the bodyguards. Your auto-aim seeks some, they're on different floors, you can't really see where they are, but it is doable to get out of bounds and shoot the bodyguards. The question, and then look, he's landed, he's here with the rocket launcher and this guard. The question is, though, could it be doable on console? He also says here on June 13th that there's a chopper. The chopper, of course, is outside and it's going to shoot you, which is challenging. Now he's saying here avoiding chopper. Let's take a look. Well, so this isn't a completed tool-assisted speedrun, but it's just an idea of what might be possible someday on the stage. So there's the chopper. He's avoiding it successfully. You know, clipping below. And then the last clip here. Full strat tutorial. You know what? Let's watch it, baby. 5 minutes? Let's watch it.
A new strategy. So, immediately after we go to the top of this lift, we want to open the door, and instead of going this way, we're going directly into the stairwell. Then we want to destroy this glass that used to be here. Then we want to do the defection SA warp. So let's see if there's this save state for that. Oops. There we go. And from here, we want to kill these two guards first of all. So to do that, I usually just walk into this bright part of the wall. It seems more consistent than the green and the other white one. So just walk into the wall like that. And then you just stand there for a while until you can see inside. And now you can lock on without aim to the first guy. And you see, if we look to the left here, we're eventually going to lose sight of the next one, so we can't really aim that way. So what you want to do is, you want to use auto-aim for the first one, and then you want to use the crosshair and R-aim the second one. Let's see if I can do this. So there's the auto-aim for the first one, and then we just want to R-aim the second one. So it shouldn't be too hard. Next, we want to run up the X. You see, as we do that, this chopper is going to spawn. You might see that chopper is already running, flying to the right here, past the corner, as you arrive. But even if it does that, it's still going to respawn over here. So the chopper will be here every time. So to avoid it, we want to run up the X while standing on the right side of the X. You see there, it doesn't see us. And even as we run up here, it's still not going to spot us. It won't spot us until it reaches the next corner. So we have some time to do this 4 kills over here. You can see if we run up the left side of the L, it's immediately going to spot us. That's a big problem. So let's see if I can do this. Like that. Now, for these next two guards, I want to stand right at the edge of this X here until the building loads, and then just aim down and shoot onto both of them pretty easily. I find it easier to get the kills if you double the crouch here, but I'm not sure if it's necessary. It's probably a good idea to do it. So after you've gotten those two kills, you want to run along this glass right here until you reach this corner. I'm just gonna kill this chopper now because it's in the way. Where is it? Okay. Okay, apparently you can deload the chopper. That's interesting. Whatever. So yeah, you run along the glass, and let have save state for this. So run all across to this corner right here, and then we want to aim, I think roughly here, like at the base of this door. And you can see auto-aim locking on. This one can be a little bit tricky, but I think as long as you're in the right position and aiming roughly the right spot, I think it should lock on. And for the last one, you can see right now we can't see the last one, so we want to aim slightly, roughly the same downwards angle, and then aim to the left and see eventually we can see the guard. But if I try to aim up now, it's gonna become black, and if I try to shoot, it's like nothing's gonna happen. So what you want to do is you want to keep your angle here, where you can see here, and then you just want to use your crosshair to kill her. So that's all there is to it, really. Then we jump down here, take the rocket launcher, and then we do the rest of the level like normal. So that's it. Good luck.
That's it. Good luck. You know, it is certainly interesting. I think we can agree that the ace world records are really, really insane. It would take a lot to beat them. You know, whether you could beat them playing the level as we've seen it played most the last 20 years is one question, or will it take something like this? And this actually sort of gets into interesting discussions on, like, sort of the end game of speedrunning. It's like, eventually, you know, speedrunning is really fun when you just start out and you're always improving. And then you kind of get a bit of struggle going, you kind of plateau, and then you start improving again, and it's really fun. But as you get to, like, the end game of speedrunning, as games get super optimized, they get, like, way more and more grindy. And eventually you have to, like, pull off strategies that are, like, one in a million to pull off, or, you know, one in thousands and thousands to pull off. And this seems like one of those strategies. You know, the idea is you clip out of bounds, you can shoot all the guards, all the bodyguards, you know, from this point, and, like, avoid having to go up and down the stairs and all that kind of stuff, right? And so, like, it probably would save time, but, like, how long would it take for you or anyone to, like, learn and master this technique? Probably super, super long. And so it's, like, quite an insane theoretical strategy that may or may never happen. And Sularak asks in chat, you know, how much time would this save? And, like, I don't think anyone really knows. Like, it hasn't even been tool-assisted speedrun to the point where we can have a good idea of how much time it might save. You know, it's that insane, it's that esoteric, it's that complicated that, like, we may never know. And I think that's the best place to leave this episode. Extraction, Special Agent, and Perfect Agent, Ace's remarkable records, and these other great records from, you know, Clem and Boss and Green and others as well. So, my friends, a huge thanks for you all for hanging out and watching tonight, and, you know, watching Speedler on YouTube or Twitch or wherever you do it, hanging out in chat. Always appreciate you guys, the lurkers. And, of course, the Speedlore Legends for supporting the series so generously over on Patreon. A huge thanks to you, Speedlore Legends, as well. I hope going to February, I'm hoping to, you know, do at least one GoldenEye episode, probably DLTK, but we'll see exactly what we decide there, and probably late February, maybe earlier in February, actually, we'll see. And I am now posting, I'm trying to post one exclusive video a month on Patreon, very niche, look at some obscure thing in GoldenEye or something like that. And I have an idea of what I'm going to do in February. So yeah, check out the Patreon if you wish. Support the series, support my work there. Truly appreciated. Once again, thanks to the Speedlore Legends, the champions, but of course everyone else who helped and hung out and engaged. Thanks to Joris for researching this episode. And hey, thanks to you for watching, my friends. Stay true, and I'll see you in the next stream or video. Good night.